الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide Him, and whomever misguide, no one will guide Him. I be witness and testify, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala almighty, and Muhammad is the last and final messenger. The thankful belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one He gathered us to seek knowledge, to share some beneficial advices. We still in the series of العقيدة أولا لو كانوا يعلمون. Faith and عقيدة is the first if the people know. And we are still in the series of يوم القيامة, the last day, the day of judgment. And we are up to the topic, the scenario number 11. Scenario number 11. And this scenario talking about very amazing live picture, live movie, live clip, whatever you can say, you can say. Those people, when they stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what will happen to them. And today, inshallah, by the will of Allah, we're going to talk about the scenario of the person being questioning about his salah. As we last lesson, we spoke about al-riya, the one he do the things not for sake of Allah, and how much he will suffer yawm al-qiyamah. Today, we're going to talk about very, very important. Wallahi, wallahi, very, very important about a person, how he will be questioned about the first question. He will be asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know what is the question? About his salah. About his prayer. This is the first questions. We are so glad from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the question we knew is not difficult for us. But only what we have to do to prepare the answer. And we should implement so our answer will be accurate and correct. You know, most of the exam in our dunya, we don't know the question. And we are suffering day and night, studying hard, you know, in order to do well in the exam. But for the exam, yawm al-qiyamah, we knew the question. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, he told us that the first question, brothers and sisters, about your salat, about your prayer. If you success, everything after that will be easy. And if not, everything will be hard, will be more hard. So this is a question. As in other hadith, that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, he said, لَا تَزُولَا قَدَمَا عَبْدٍ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ حَتَّى يُسْأَلَ عَنْ أَرْبَعَ. In the يوم القيامة, the day of judgment, no person will go to the next stage, we can say, until he been asked four questions. عن عمره فيما أفناه, about his lifetime, what he did in it. وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه, about his youth, what he done for it. His youth time, when he's active, when he's young, he's strong, how he spent his youth time. وعن ماله من أين اكتسبه وفيما أنفقه, and about his wealth, from where he earned his money, and from where and for where he put his money. Where he spent his money. وعن ماله من أين أخذه وفيما أنفقه وعن علمه ماذا عمل به. And about his knowledge, what he did for it. So this is in this hadith, we knew the question, brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so merciful, so much mercy that he will not leave us. We don't know what we've been asked Yawm al-Qiyamah. We knew that question. Only Allah wants from us to prepare for that question. Very small, very easy preparation. Just your salat. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligation, fardu ayn, faridah, over each single person. Five salat, five prayer a day and night, in the day of night, and night. So, very simple, very easy. So what we did do for that order, are we surely praying five times a day? Are we surely praying accurately and correctly the way of Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him? Are we surely praying five times a day with a khushu', with a sincerity, with the ikhlas, with the attention, with a khushu', our mind there all the time when we are praying to Allah? This is a big mark question for me, brothers and sisters, and for everyone. Since I knew that the first question will be about salah, the first things I should in my life after Shahada to Tawheed, I should prepare for that question, true or not. The first thing, before you think about the other thing, about, start with your salah. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, this is the key of all success. Wallahi, I swear by the name of Allah, that the salah is the key for all success. Success in dunya, by feeling happy and comfort and good feeling and exciting and refreshment in dunya and in akhirah when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the salah will lift you up and make all your question after that easier. Because if your salah accepted by Allah, everything after that, it will be much easier, according the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you want, would like to write the hadith, hadith on sahih, rawahu al-imam al-tirmidhi wa ghayrihim, it's mentioned in many books, more than 7 of the books of the hadith, that the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, he said, inna awwala ma yuhasabu bihi al-abdu yawm al-qiyamati min amalihi salatuhu. فإن صلحت فقد أفلح وأنجح وإن فسدت فقد خاب وخسر. The first question that the servant will be asked, the first question the servant will be asked يوم القيامة from his أعمال, from his deeds, الصلاة, صلاته, his prayer. فَإِنْ صَلُحَتْ, and if his salah, صَلُحَتْ mean fixed and good, accurate, accepted. فَإِنْ صَلُحَتْ فَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ وَأَنْجَحَ. How beautiful the word of Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, أَفْلَحَ mean success. He will be successful. وَأَنْجَحَ, he will be pass the exam. نجاح mean pass. وَإِنْ فَسَدَتْ, and if his salah is corrupted and is not accepted, فَقَدْ خَابَ وَخَسِرَ. خَابَ mean he will be lost and lose. He will be lost and lose. وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. Do you like to be among of the loser? No way. Nobody like this one. معاذ الله, may Allah save us and protect us from the khasara, from the losing. So here So see how beautiful when you seek knowledge, when you knew that the first question, and every time of the salah, brothers and sisters, you remember, now is a salah of dhuhr. The first question is salat. Let me do it properly. Let me do it accurately. Let me do it in the best as much I can. Let me do the salah with the conditions of salah, ash-shurutu salah. Let me apply wajibatu salah. Let me apply the sunan salah. Let me be away from mubtilatu salah. What is batal? Make salah, my salah batal. Or batila, or not accepted. Let me be aware from what is the ahkam, the rules of salah. Have you ever asked yourself, today I want to go to Shaykh and Alim and scholars and a person he follows Sunnah. I tell him, please, Ustaz, Shaykh, I want to show you my wudu. I want to show you the way I pray. Is it accurate and correct? Have you ever thought this thought? This is really important. Very, very important. If you would like to start a new business, you ask a person, which is the best location, what's the best business I should do, who should I ask, how much budget I need, how much profit I can make. You keep maybe investigate some people 1 year. And a big company, sometimes if they would like to open the franchise, they do investigation for the place maybe 2-3 months. So this is the first question in Yawm al-Qiyamah. Let me find out about my salat. Have you ever read a book about salah? Or just you inherit the salah since you was year one? The teacher teach me something about salat and I hold on and I carry on. Now I am knowledgeable, I am adult, I am mature. Did I read? What is the sunan of salah? What is fara'id salah? How I pray? What is mubtilat salah? So this is really important. Wallahi, very, very important. Because I can tell you, most the Muslims nowadays, they inherit the salah from the father or mother. They did not learn how to do salah. Just they see the father and mother doing this, they follow. And they carry on all his life. And some of the Muslim, maybe all his life, his salah not acceptable. He's not praying properly and accurately. Subhanallah. So this is really, really important now for us, is a wake-up call for us to check about our salah, because our salah is really, really important. When the person stand Yawm al-Qiyamah and the first question come to him about his salah, hear the success from the Al-Quran. Qala ta'ala, you can see in the board, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قد أفلح المؤمنون الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون قد أفلح المؤمنون الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين. This ayat is similarity in two surahs, Surah Al-Mu'minun and also Surah Al-Ma'arij. Okay, I mix with the Surah Al-Ma'arij and Surah Al-Mu'minun. The Surah Al-Mu'minun, the last ayah, talking about the attribute of the believer. The last one, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the attribute of the believer. This Surah Al-Mu'minun, the believer. And Allah starts mentioning, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ. Indeed, surely, certainly. What? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ. أَفْلَحَ means success. Surely they success. Surely they success. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ. المؤمنون, the believer. The believer. The first attribute, the first description for them, what is that? What is that, sisters? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. The first attribute. Nowadays, oh, Islam, so many things, I cannot, you know, so much topics. Fiqh, Tawheed, Aqeedah, Seerah, oh, so confusing. I cannot learn everything. I want to be a success, ya Ustaz. Habibi, brothers and sisters, very easy. It's in the surah mentioned. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. The first attribute, you want to be successful? Be in your salah with a khushu'. Be in your salah with the full of sincerity, full of attention towards Allah, full your heart belong to Allah during the salah, your heart linked to Allah, you have a full of khushu', you humble yourself to Allah. The khushu' is a very wide word. Wallahi, there is no English similar meaning. Khushu', it's many, many, many things. That's your soul attached to Allah. Your heart a link to Allah. Your mind linked to the word of Allah. What is being recited? MashaAllah, Ustaz, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. And your mind, ah, my wife, she cooking the cake. Ah, the cake, you know? The cake, let's finish, you know, before the children eat it. SubhanAllah. Or, you know, the wife, ah, oh, I forget the food on the fire. Ya Allah, when I finish my salah too. This is a problem in our salah. Wallahi, يعني, I'm telling you, this is a common problem. Even we fighting ourselves all the time from shaitan, fighting shaitan, pushing him away. In order to have one salah, wallahi, if one salah I do with a khushu', I feel I am the most happiest one. Because not easy. Ah, shaitan will not let you to be peaceful mind. He always instruct you. Try to make you remember everything. And there is, subhanAllah, funny story. A person, he came and he complained to Ibn Sirin, one of the Salaf, the olden days, mashallah. He's a very pious person. Also, he's famous in explaining the dream. Do you know here in Malaysia, some ulama, they interpret the dream and explain the dream for the people? Do you have something like that? I don't. Now, mashallah, in Arab country now, a lot of ulama, even they have a live show on TV. People call and ask about the dream and they will explain. But subhanAllah, Allah opened their heart and mind. They can view very deep. Of course, some people fake, some people follow the Quran and Sunnah. We are talking about the people who follow the Quran and Sunnah and the knowledge from them, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this is skills given from Allah. It's not studied by book. If you open the book of Ibn Sirin and read all the book about explaining the dream, then you explain it's not right. Sometimes the same dream, from person to person, different explanation. From person to person. This person is religious, explained differently. This person, not religious, also explained differently. Or sometimes single and married, also different. So... So how can I say that really, really important? So Ibn Sirin, a person when he came to him and he asked him, oh, Shaykh Alim, I put money, so much money, gold, in one place and subhanAllah, afterward, I forget where I put it. I forget where I put my gold. This is so much money. I put it somewhere, but because of the time, I forgot. I'm trying to remember, I cannot. Then Ibn Sirin, he gave him a good solution. You know what he said to him? Can you imagine? He told him, go and pray. Pray to Allah subhanahu and try to avoid shaitan and nothing, anything from dunya. SubhanAllah, after maybe a couple of days, he came to him. He said, I found it. He said, how? He said, I tried to push the shaitan away from my mind in the salah, one salah, two salah. He reminded me about my treasure. Then I come out from the salah, I got it. SubhanAllah, he tried all the way to push the khushu' away from him. He did not success shaitan. Then he reminded him about his treasure. This is the only way to spoil his salah. SubhanAllah. So this is how, يعني, shaitan try to play hard in the mind of a person when he's doing salat. So when we remember this, wallahi, this is a big key to have khushu'. First teeth of the tea, that you remember the first question is about salat. This is the first teeth of that key. Second one, remember that you are praying to Allah. If the name of Allah is so high in your heart, and everything in dunya is nothing compared to Allah, this is help you a lot to get the khushu'. This is we call the second teeth of the key. The third one I can tell, remember as you are in the Mecca, are you praying in front of your Kaaba? I think all of you went to Umrah, maybe young sister, I'm not sure, but I'm sure maybe all of you went to Umrah. Tell me the truth. When you pray there, is the same way you're praying here? Tell me, what is the answer? Totally different. You feel different in the salah. You fill your mind with the khushu', ya Allah, Makkah, the holy place. The salah here is 100,000 reward. Allahu Akbar, how beautiful. So if every salah, you try to remember that Makkah, you are in Makkah, in the Kaaba in front of you, it helps you to get the khushu'. Number four of the teeth of the key of the salat to have the khushu', remember that the malaika of al-hasanat, the angels of writing the reward in my right hand, he's writing. So try to get and score as much you can from the reward. And there is a hadith that a person, he prayed the salah, and what is written from that salah, quarter of the salah, third of the salah, or eighth of the salah. Can you imagine a person praying, only he get reward eighth? Yani one part of eight parts of the reward. Yani let's say the salah, it's rewarded by, let's say, 800 hasana. He will get only 100. And some of the people, he not get anything except the tiring. نسأل الله العفو والعافية والعياذ بالله. And there's another hadith that the salah will be put in the thawb, in the cloth, in the garment. So if his salah very good, the garment will be lift up to the heaven, the reward. And if the person, والعياذ بالله, it did not do the salah, no khushu', nothing, is not correct, the garment will be thrown in his face. That will be not accepted to Allah. And the ulama al-salihin, they used to say, if two raka'ah Allah accepted from me, I'm so glad, I'm so happy. Because Allah says, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Indeed, Allah will accept from the muttaqeen. At least I have taqwa, I have a fearness to Allah. I am aware, subhanallah. So this is the taqwa, is really achievement of the salah. How to get taqwa? We read in the Quran so many verses, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ. Allah loves, indeed, Allah loves the muttaqeen. I want to be muttaqi. I want to be muttaqi. So how I achieve taqwa? Through the salah. through the salah. Also, through the salah, awareness of Allah will be elevate high. Plus, the salah will push me away from the munkar, al-fahsha wal-munkar. What does mean fahsha and munkar? The sin and evil and bad deeds. So, how to save yourself from fahsha and munkar, from the evil, from the bad deeds, from whatever? The through the salah. قال تعالى إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. Indeed, salah will be saver from the evil deeds, from the corruption and corrupted, and from the sin, فحشاء والمنكر. سبحان الله. So a person, I tell you, this story happened to me. When we migrate to Australia in 1999, one of my member of my relative, he first time he born in Australia, he never know about Salat, he never know about Islam. He's a Muslim, but only name. When I talk to him, wallahi, brother and sister, the first da'wah I start with the Tawheed about the Salah, because he's not praying. And I keep talking to him about Salah almost 1 month. And he be irritated from me. So much irritated. Ah, this person, every time I meet him, talk to me about Salah. Subhanallah, I try to be friend to him to understand why he's not praying. Finally, he declared. He told me, Muaz, how can I do Salat? And I go to club, I have girlfriend, I drink alcohol. I do all these bad things. I say, no problem. I will take you to the club if you want. But do Salat. Oh, what are you talking? Are you guide me? I said, no problem. Meet Allah with some good deeds, better than nothing. Wallahi, this is a true story. It's happened to me. He went straight away after I talked to him. He did wudu. I teach him about wudu. And I pray with him. And he prayed the first Salah in his life. In three days or four days, he traveled back to Arab country to marry, and he never smoked after that. He stopped alcohol, he stopped girlfriend, nothing. He changed his life from the Salat. Can you imagine Salah? What is change the person? If we really do the Salah properly, with the khushu', with the sincerity. SubhanAllah, this is the key of da'wah. Sometimes we wrong giving da'wah. We tell them, you are doing haram, haram. طيب, talk to him about salah, brothers. He's never praying. You tell him about something. Start step by step. You know, lady, she never wear hijab. She never pray. She has a bad friends. The first things you tell, you wear hijab. Before you tell her wear hijab, let her do salah first. You know, don't make this Islam difficult on people. Let her do salah. Tell her, sister, how come you face Allah and you are so ignorant and you so away from Allah that you never put your head down to Him? Do salah. It only takes from you 10 minutes. You feel so calm, so happy, so close to your God. You feel the sincerity. You feel the... You know that all your worriness go will be away, push away. So tell him about the virtue of Salat. Wallahi, this person, if he taste, you know what I mean taste? Taste the sweetness of Salah. Wallahi, nothing compare. All the enjoyable things in the dunya, nothing compare with 2 rak'ah to Allah, that the tears flowing away for Allah. What a beautiful 2 rak'ah to Allah, to Almighty, and you reading, reciting the Quran, you decorate your voice to Allah, recite nicely, beautifully, Surah Al-Fatiha, reading to Al-Quran, bow yourself to Almighty, and you say, Subhan Rabbi Al-Azim, Subhan Rabbi Al-Azim, Subhan Rabbi Al-Azim, سبحان ربي الأعلى. Glory be to Allah, the Most High. Glory be to Allah, the Greatest. What a beautiful thing. So nice. You feel the sweetness. Wallahi, we need Allah. We need to complain to Him. Ya Allah, I have so much problems in my wealth, in my children, in my family, in my health. Ya Allah, help me. You ask Him. You pray to Him. You supplicate to Him. You sincere to Him. Tell me, what is the result? You will achieve so much deep, so much sweetness in you feel inside yourself. You feel so much happy. That is the things. That's what we are looking for. Wallahi, salah is not difficult. Salah is the time for enjoyable. As-salah is the time for enjoyment. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, peace be upon him. You know what he used to say to Abu Bilal? Arihna biha ya Bilal. Arihna biha ya Bilal. Arihna biha ya Bilal. Make us feel relaxed by salah. Let us make us feel relaxed, O Bilal, by salah. Yalla, start iqama. Because the sahaba waiting for the iqama. Then when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tell Bilal, yalla, arihna biha. Do iqama. Make us relax. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him. In the hadith, when they mention that حُبِّبَ إِلَيَّ مِن دُنْيَاكُمْ ثَلَاثْ, I loved from this dunya three things. Women's. So halal to love women, but only your wife, huh? Your halal one. So this is a good thing, the beauty of the dunya. وَإِنَّ مَتَاعَ الدُّنْيَا الزَّوْجَ الصَّالِحَةِ. The beauty of the dunya, the pious wife. So this is the most things that a man he like, beautiful and biased wife. This is the most enjoyable man from the dunya, for the person from this dunya. Okay, you know why? Not only for desire, because if he look at to her, he feel happy. When he talk to her, he feel happy. When he share with her, he feel happy. This is the beauty of the dunya. Halal, nothing haram. Nowadays, unfortunately, they put in the TV that the boyfriend and girlfriend and romantic story, the true love only with haram relationship. And always with the true love story, with the husband and wife, always show fighting, cheating, hating, hitting. They want to inherit in that the husband and wife, not nice. Boyfriend and girlfriend is a time of enjoyment. Astaghfirullah. That is what inject our generation. Inject them with the poisons, poison after poison. And they doesn't know that the true happiness with the halal relationship. Wallahi, the haram relationship, so much disgusting, disease, AIDS, etc. Unhappy, cannot sleep, scared, worried. A'udhu billah. It's so disgusting. Halal relationship, happy, calm, rizqi, barakah, rahmah, children. What is on the TV? Are you agree with me? What is the most of the the movie stuff? Most of the movie talking about haram relationship is the nice life, and the halal relationship always, problem. Astaghfirullah. May Allah save us from this corrupted, movie, TV. We call them in Arabic mufsidyon, ليس تلفزيون. The real name تلفزيون, TV. مفسديون من الفساد. Fasad means corruption. Mufsidyon, the corrupted one. Subhanallah. Now our ustaz, our sheikh, our teacher, our treacherer, our master is the TV. Internet. Facebook. Oh, may Allah save us. Okay, come back to my topic. So, salah is really the key of happiness. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to say to Bilal, أرحنا بها يا بلال. Make us relax with the salah. And the hadith, sorry, I didn't continue. حُبِّبَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ دُنْيَاكُمْ ثَلَاثْ. I love from this dunya three things. Women's wa perfume. And the most beloved to my heart during my time of salah. Ya Allah. وَجُعْلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. The most beloved to me is like the eye for my body. What is that? Salat. Subhanallah. So test yourself. Put the, what do you call, the tester. Is this the salah is the most beloved time to me, or the most hard time? Oh, when I finish my salah, I want to, you know, hit the task and finish. Oh, I have so much things. So this is very, very, you know, important to test ourselves, that is the salah really our happy time or not. And the hadith, the one will be shade in the Yawm al-Qiyamah, one of them, وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ. And a man, his heart attached to the masjid. Salatul Dhuhr is coming. Al-Asr is the time of Asr. Oh, let me catch the salah. Let me catch the masjid. We are in the highway. Oh, we have to catch the time. You are with the friends. Oh, brother. Oh, the time of salah. Is any masjid nearby? Yeah, try to find. Let's hear the adhan. Let's do salat. Then we do our job. So this is how this person, his person, his heart attached to the mosque, attached to the masjid. And also sister, her heart should be attached to the time of salah. Pray on time. In another hadith, قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, when the person, he asked الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, peace be upon him, ما هي ما أحب الأعمال إلى الله, the most beloved to Allah from the deeds, from the good deeds, from عبادة. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, الصلاة على وقتها, صلاة on time. قلت ثم أي, what is the next? قال بر الوالدين, to be dutiful to parents. قلت ثم أي, قال الجهاد في سبيل الله. Jihad, fighting in the battle of, fighting in the path of Allah. So the first one, salah on time. Subhanallah, I have one relative, she is very old woman, almost now 85 or something. She's very old. MashaAllah, this lady. She just heard the adhan, I see her, before adhan already have wudu. She heard the adhan, Wallahu Akbar, finish, La ilaha illallah. The end of the adhan, Bismillah, after dua, start salat. On time. I wish, I see her delay a salah one time. I want to see you. Wallahi, I feel so sorry to myself. On time. Subhanallah. This is how the true believer. On time. On salah, on time. So this is, inshallah, a reminder for me and for you, brothers and sisters. قال تعالى إن هذا سورة بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ما سلككم في سقر قالوا لم نك من المصلين ولم نك نطعم المسكين وكنا نخوض مع الخائضين وكنا نكذب بيوم الدين حتى أتانا اليقين. This is سورة المدثر آية 42. ما سلككم في السقر. The angels asking the people of fire, والعياذ بالله, the hellfire, because as I said in last time, hellfire is دركات. دركات mean stages, but not stairs, down, والعياذ بالله. Saqar, one of the stages, very severe, very painful. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Very painful. مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَر. What is, the angel asked them, what is make you or made you be here in Saqar? What the first? Because of what? لم نكن من المصلين. we wasn't among of the people doing salat. The first here, attribute of the believer, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. They who are during their prayer humbly submit, or يعني خشوع. Why there were خاشعين. The first attribute of those people in hellfire, قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. And wallahi, question come to my mind, how O believer, thinking you will be in Jannah if you never prostrate or do sujood to Allah? How you are willing to achieve the mercy of Allah and you are so proud, so ignorant to do sujood even when sajda to Allah? For your information, brothers and sisters, that the most highly opinion, which is based from the hadith and Quran, that the person never pray, he is not Muslim. And if he die, we are forbidden to do janazah to him and buried in the Muslim graveyard. Can you imagine how dangerous it is? Umar ibn al-Khattab, he said, we don't know any sin in Islam that made person die as a kafir except salat. And there is a hadith, al-ahd alladhi baynana wa baynahum as-salah. Al-ahd mean the difference between us and the kuffar is the prayer. فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. And whomever denied or leave the salah, فَقَدْ كَفَرَ, he fall in kufr. وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ, he fall in disbelief. Very dangerous. So, how many brothers and sisters nowadays that he knew that his son or his nephew or his cousin or his whatever relate, he never prayed to Allah. And we are smiling and happy with him, other than to advise him and wake him, give him a wake-up call. And we knew if he die like this, he will be in Jahannam al-'Adhab Billah. So we don't have a heart to rescue that person by deliver a message to him. Wallahi, if we knew that car have a problem and he is going to drive this car, it might be have accident, we stop him. No, don't drive. And we knew if he die in this state, he will be die as a wal'adhu billah. He will be in punishment. And it's okay. We are enjoying with him. We laughing with him. Where is the nasiha? Where is the advice? This is really important, wallahi. So we should care about salat. The first dalil, qala ta'ala, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى وقوموا لله قانتين. حافظوا يعني care, pray. حافظوا من المحافظة, keep your salah, keep doing the salat. على الصلاة والصلاة الوسطى, and the middle prayer. What is the middle prayer? العصر. And there is another hadith, من صلى البردين دخل الجنة. Whoever pray البردين, he will be enter Jannah. Al-Bardain is Al-Fajr and Al-Asr. And this is the most hardest Salat, because Fajr is too early, people sleeping. While Asr, he is maybe tired from the work or in the middle of the work. Also, Salat Al-Isha is very, you know, very hard for the hypocrite, Munafiqeen. They will be lazy to pray. So this is Salawat, is really, really important. Also, Allah mentioned that the salah is tijaratun rabiha, successful trading. قال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الذين يتلون كتاب الله وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية يرجون تجارة لن تبور. إن الذين, indeed, those who reciting Al-Quran, يتلون كتاب الله, وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ, and they perform salat. وَأَنْفَقُوا, and they give نفقة. They give donation from what Allah give them, gave them. سرا وعلانية, secretly and openly. يرجون تجارة, they are hoping trading that will never lose, that type of trading will never lose. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never make them lose. Their niyat, they trading with Allah. They do tijara with Allah. They dealing with Allah. And Allah, whomever deal with Allah, he will never be a loser. He will never lose. Dealing with the people, of course, one time you success, one time you lose. One time you make money, one time you make problem. He will be in trouble. But when you deal with Allah, all the time you success. All the time will be success. Number three, we have to care about salah because the salah wipe our sin. Wipe. You want to buy eraser to wipe your sin? Salah is your eraser, erasing all the sin. Subhanallah. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم in the hadith, أرأيتم لو أن نهرا بباب أحدكم يغتسل منه كل يوم خمس مرات هل يبقى من درنه شيء؟ قالوا لا يبقى من درنه شيء. قال فذلك مثل الصلوات الخمس يمحو الله بهن الخطايا. حديث صحيح رواه الإمام البخاري. Number of the hadith 505. This hadith, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he asked the Sahaba, how about, he asked them a question, أرأيتم, how about if you seen a person, if you seen a person next to him river, and he wash himself 5 times a day, do you think any dirty will left over on his body? Of course, nothing, all be clean, because he clean himself 5 times a day. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he give an example. This is like the salat. Allah wipe the sin. So the salat is the key of forgiveness. Subhanallah, key of forgiveness. Salah. If you made any sin, you just run away to do, pray to Allah 2 rak'ah, and be sincere and ask forgiveness from Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, and have in your heart that you'll not do it again, salah surely will be wiping your sin. Number four, حافظوا على الصلاة, care about salah and keep doing salah. Why? Because salah tanha عن الفحشاء والمنكر. The salah will be tanha, mean forbid you from all the evil deeds. And wallahi, personally, and I'm sure you also realize that, if you do salat, after the salah, you finish, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, somebody play music. Later, why is this music now? Even if you're listening to the music, I'm talking about the person, he's listening music. When he finished salah, Allah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, close the music, I'm just still doing dhikr. Yani he feel disgusting to do these things. Because now he doing salat, his iman up. He doesn't like these things. Later on, the iman down, enjoying the music. This is a problem of the people. Because the salah left iman up. And if a person is iman strong, if you tell him, come, you know, follow this lady, or the lady, you know, ask her, follow this man in haram way, he will say, astaghfirullah, what are you talking? But when the iman very weak, let's be friend, let me try these things. Because the iman low. Always try to put your iman up. When a person tell him, take interest, and your iman strong, no, astaghfirullah, it's okay, what I earn is enough. I don't want to be involved in these stupid things. And when your iman weak, everybody doing these things, it's okay, you know, there's so much fatwa, you know, trading fatwa. Easy fatwa, it's okay, you do these things, then it's alright, it's only a house, I need it, so that is how the problem. When your iman up, you will be away from sin. When your iman down, you fall in sin. So as we are Muslim, we shouldn't, leave ourselves with a weak iman. Always try to lift our iman up. So this is a key, salat. Okay, number five. حافظوا على الصلاة, care about salah, because the salah is the reason للتمكين في الأرض وسبب لنصرة المسلمين. It's a reason for the victory. Now the ummah is weak. The ummah of Muslim is very weak. We've been killed everywhere. We've been slandered and insulted everywhere. Subhanallah. One of the reasons that the Muslim, they are weak, because they are away from salah. Salah is the reason to get the victory from Allah. And wallahi, I hear that story about from the Israeli man, Jewish. He said, oh Muslim, he said a word, very golden statement. He said, we will not afraid from you or scared from you until if you see you praying in Salatul Fajr the same way, same number of Jum'ah. If the number of the people attend the masjid in Salatul Fajr morning prayer, same number of the people attending and praying Jum'ah, here we shake. We will be scared. We are not scared from you even if you have the strongest weapon. Here we, because we fight you with the, because of the iman. When the Muslims, they have the iman, the word of Allah in their heart, the love to the religion so much, and they are willing to sacrifice to pray Salatul Fajr and cut their sleep and pray on the masjid, of course the enemies will be shaking. Is it true or not? Wallahi, if our youth now in the masjid praying the same number like a Jum'ah, militia different. Wallahi, I swear by Allah, you will hear every day more than hundreds of people become Muslim. But our mind of the youth, different world. They want to get certificate, they want to marry, they want to get a car, they want to get a job, they want to success, and all the dunya things. And they forget the last thing about salah. Ah, salah is good, yeah, I like it. This is must be on the top of your things. Pray in the masjid. You are young, you're strong, you have muscles. What is making you aware to pray in the masjid, jama'ah? Ah, busy, working. Is the working better than Allah? What's wrong if you pray in the masjid? Wallahi, if the youth dedicate themselves to pray on masjid on time, and whatever the job they are working, and all the bosses knew in Malaysia that all the Muslims in the time of Salah, they must go to masjid, and they respect these things, and after the masjid they continue their work, wallahi, you will see a big change. Why? In Saudi Arabia, they do this. All the shops close in the, during the Salah time. I've been there, all the shops close and people go to masjid to pray. They can apply. They will not, I didn't see them, they're losing, they make more money. Subhanallah, wallahi. Even their salary better than some of the other countries. Subhanallah. Salah doesn't make you decrease your money, it's increasing your money. Revive your iman. So here we have to plant in the heart of the people, this youth, important of salah in masjid. When the people go to masjid, they start sharing and caring and unity. You see the unity of Islam. We all pray together. We all, subhanallah, you know, help each other. Here the iman will be strong and the ummah, the victory comes. I remember one brother, when I used to miss one salah from masjid, next salah, I'm so worried, he will ask me, ah, you see me, salam alaikum, Muaz, I wrote you absent, salat al-dhuhr, why didn't come? And they say, Allahu Akbar, here we have a big eye watching us. So subhanAllah, this is really help. helped me a lot that I shouldn't miss. But when the ummah here, you miss all the salah, you never go to masjid, nobody will call, talk to you, even nobody SMS you. Brother, you've been 2-3 days, you didn't come to masjid. Of course, I will be lazy. Next time, that's okay. It's no problem. This is also important to pray in masjid. That the Sahaba, radiallahu anhum, they used to say, we knew that a person is not come to the masjid and pray with us, he is among the munafiqeen. Look how all the Muslim, good Muslim, they pray in masjid. And who is pray at home, he is maybe hypocrite or have something problem. Nowadays, subhanAllah, I realize the masajid, you can go, who praying in the masjid? 50 and above. Is it? Problem. I tell you a practical experience. I think 8 years ago, whatever, when the biggest masjid in Sydney, we used to go to masjid, most of the first line, second line, third line, all the old people. All of them, 50, 60, 70, 80, I don't know, 80, 70, above. SubhanAllah. Youth, very rare to see young man. SubhanAllah. One da'iyah, he study Islamic and he start da'wah for youth. Start for them classes, once a week, and da'wah, motivation, story of the prophets, and whatever. Slowly, the youth more come to the masjid. SubhanAllah. Then he start a program. He appoints 7 leaders, every leader under him 10 or 20. And each leader, same, you know, mind, like those people of handyman together, those educated together, those is age period together. So they divide them. And the leader, he is responsible that all under him come to the masjid in Fajr. They start for Fajr, only Fajr. Because if they do the Fajr, everything easier. All the salah much easier. Wallahi, SMSing. Brother, why you give missed call? Brother, wake up. Only 15 minutes for Iqama. Wallahi, I prayed one time in masjid. I shocked. I can say 4 line or 5 line youth, young man. Some of them, they have a tattoo. Just repent to Allah. So this is what we have to apply in our ummah nowadays. We need to implement something for our youth. You are the mother, you are the grandmother. Tell them, wake up them. Make sure you SMS them, yeah, my son, pray in masjid, Habibi. Give him a drink. Give him Coca-Cola in the morning. Tell him, this is Coca-Cola, this is Pepsi. 10 ringgit for you, hadiya, illa, illa. Prepare his bag. Go to masjid, pray on jama'ah. Yeah, wake him up. Yeah. This is your duty. Can you imagine? Yes, it's tiring. Wallahi, I tell you, tiring. But can you imagine if you pray in masjid, he will get 27 reward, and you get all the reward he did comes to you. Because you are the one guide for the good. Then after, I'm sure, 6 months later, if you every day own him, 6 months later, he become, you know, part of his life. Oh, time I have to wake up. My mom will come, you know. Let me go before she come. Okay? Then, I'm sure if he really, his heart, the love of Salah comes inside his heart, he start applied on his son, children. Wallahi. I am personally more than 6 years over my sisters in the morning. Wake them up. My father cannot help. He wake up them almost half an hour, they're still lazy. Me, they knew. I'm no joke. One time, good, nicely. Second time, more nicely. Third time, water coming. The gun of the water coming over you. So, okay, Allah, let's go. Salat. SubhanAllah. Now, Alhamdulillah, I see the children praying. They apply that things on their children. You get reward. You are the one invent this. SubhanAllah, can you imagine if your son have a final exam? I'm sure you wake him up 2 o'clock in the morning. Go study, final exam tomorrow. Exam of Akhirah is more important. This is what we want to apply an idea, technical. Not whatever I said is not important to apply same way. Try to be creative. Maybe some in Malay culture, they have a different style. You do whatever as long the result is Salah on Masjid. You do whatever your result, you know. Whatever way it can help. Some of son, he need hadiyah. Some son need, you know, pressure. You know, some of different. You know the technique. But as long place the heart in his heart love of salah, and you know, in Islam they say Rasul ﷺ in hadith, umuru awladakum bis salati li sab', order them for salah when they are 7 years old. Wadribuhum, hit them if they are reached the age of 10 if they miss the salah. Can you imagine nowadays I say, Islam is hard? No, because this little hit he get once in his life, but salah becomes something very nice. Subhanallah. I tell you a story happened to me when I was a child. You know Shisha. Subhanallah. One time I went with my father and brothers. To my father used to fix everything related to restaurant, whatever. His job, like this. So I went with him as a child. Maybe I was in year 4 at school. So I see a shisha is empty. And as I'm, you know, a child, like to try it. And I'm just coming close to my mouth. My brother from the back, slap me. I remember the slap. Small slap, you know, not that painful. But it's give me awakening. Wallahi, since that time, until today, I never put shisha, or I'm thinking to put shisha in my mouth or smoke. Just this hit give me a lesson forever. Small hit, but give me awakening. I'm not saying to you, hit hard. I'm just saying you how important the salah. You are allowed to hit little bit the child in order to know how important the salah. Salah is really important. Salah is really, really, really important. Because if that son or child grow up with the love of salah, the salah will save him and protect him all his life from the bad things. And you know the fitna around us. Wallahi, we are the, you know, study Islam, we facing the fitna. How about the youth in the street? Of course they facing so much fitna. You cannot blame them. Society like this. You cannot make them as the sahaba facing all this fitna until they have love of salah, love of Quran, love of Allah inside their heart. Then inshallah they can fight inside themselves about the fitna, and they can, you know, go up beyond the fitna, and they will be success. So this is inshallah small advice to me. Oh, so much things I didn't mention from the topic. Okay, let me go to the end. So the final concluding, Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, one of the sahabi, said, "Man sarrahu an yalqa Allah ta'ala ghadan muslima." Whomever he pleased to meet Allah, Muslim, real Muslim. So, فَلْيُحَافِظْ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ الصَّلَوَاتِ. يعني care about this salat. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ شَرَعَ لِنَبِيِّكُمْ سُنَنْ الْهُدَى. The sunan of guidance is the salat. Subhanallah, look at here. Very scary, wallahi. May Allah forgive us. وَلَوْ أَنَّكُمْ صَلَّيْتُمْ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ. And if you pray at home, if you pray at home and not pray in the masjid, you will miss the sunnah of your prophet. Because the sunnah of a prophet to pray on masjid. And if you miss the sunnah of the prophet, you might go to the way of misguided. Subhanallah. So this is a very, very, very important saying. And he said, if the person, he go and clean and purify himself, the wudu, then he go to masjid, to any masjid, Allah will write for him in each step he walk good deeds, and lift him one high level, and for wipe one sin. And this is referred to the man. That's the prayer in the masjid, recommended, highly recommended to the man. Some of the ulama, they said wajib. Okay? So this is for the man. For the woman, she will get more reward as much she go more hidden place in her house. So in the salon, if she pray, she get reward. In her bedroom, more rewarded. She more hide herself, she more get reward from Allah. But in that, nothing haram. If the woman plan to go to masjid to pray on jama'ah, also no problem. It's a lawful, and the husband not allowed to stop his wife doing this in Islam. If you feel, if you pray in masjid with the sisters, she revive your iman, or you hear some good class, good lecture, no problem, pray at home, masjid. So this is the, inshallah, important about the salah, important praying in masjid, also important of the salah. Last one, I want to mention the hadith, the ayah from Al-Quran, Surah Maryam, ayah 59. Really scary one, because really scary. The topic is really scary about the salah in Yawm Al-Qiyamah. Something really, really, better to be scared now than later. Better. Remember the salah, first question. Allah says in the Quran, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. فخلف من بعدهم خلف أضاعوا الصلاة واتبعوا الشهوات فسوف يلقون غيا. فخلف من بعدهم, يعني generation came after them, because the previous ayah talking about the messengers and prophet, when they hear the word of Allah, they used to do sujood and they cry, خروا سجدا وبكيا. And here this ayah they have a sujood. Surah Maryam. If you open the Surah Maryam, where is the sajda? Here the ayah mentioned. So the next ayah, what I'm reciting now, فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ, the generation came after them. خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةِ. أَضَاعُوا mean they lost their prayer. They lost their salat. وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ, and they follow the desires. Ya Latif, Ya Latif. فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. They will facing غيّة. غيّة والعياذ بالله in the علماء or في المفسرون, they said غيّة is a place in hellfire, that the hellfire ask refuge from that place. Hellfire himself, herself ask refuge from that place. How painful and so much punishment in it. والعياذ بالله, والعياذ بالله, غيّة. فسوف يلقون غيا. They said valley والعياذ بالله in hellfire. So we don't want to be among of those people whom lost their prayer and follow their desires. Haram one, of course. So these two conditions push it away. Do care about your salah. Don't lost it. And they said Abdullah bin Mas'ud, I think, or if I'm not mistaken, he said أضاعوا الصلاة, they lost their salat, doesn't mean they stop praying. That's so scary. He said, doesn't mean that they stop praying, but they delay the salah on time. They pray dhuhr in time of asr, asr in time of maghrib, isha and fajr. They delay the salah and they not do it in a proper way. Ya Latif. So scary. Scary ayat. Jahannam place for them, wal'adhu billah. So anybody says, because of the work, I delay salah, because of this, I delay salah. No, no. Pray on time. Don't let the dunya control your life. Let the deen control your life. The dunya follow the deen. Come after. So this is what, because Allah, you know, if the boss, you think he will stop your work, Allah will not stop your rizq. Because the rizq is not from your boss, from Allah. Even if you you might doing the job properly and very good, you are sincere to your job, and you delay the salah, don't worry about the salah. Maybe the boss, he has so much worker, he can stop you. He said, please, tomorrow don't come. True or not? True? He might not need you anymore. But Allah will never stop rizqi on you. Since you come to the dunya until you meet him, he's still giving you. So the salah is very easy. And the only ibadah being ordered directly to Allah, straight away to the Prophet Muhammad without Jibreel, Salah. How important is? So inshallah, I wish that small reminder for me and for you, every day try to account your salah. And my advice to myself and you, pray more sunnah, more nafila, in case my salah not very good, the sunnah will cover, the nafila will cover, because in the yawm al-qiyamah, whatever missing, they will be taken from your sunnah, from your nafila to complete. So if the person, he didn't do sunnah, he didn't do nafila, from where he can get to complete his salat? So sunnah mean 2 rak'ah before fajr, 4 rak'ah before dhuhr, 2 rak'ah after dhuhr, maghrib, 2 rak'ah after maghrib, isha, 2 rak'ah after isha, total 12. And there's a hadith, whomever pray other than farida 12 rak'ah, Allah will build for him a house in Jannah. Allah will build for him a house in Jannah. So you get a house every day, mashallah, so beautiful, no need to get a loan and spend 20 years paying back. Every day get a free house in Jannah by doing 12 rak'ah, very easy. Subhanallah. So this is a reward by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you deal with Allah, you will be success for sure. Barakallahu feekum wa jazakumullahu khayran wa ahsanullahu ilaykum. Subhanaka Allahumma rabbana wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ya Allah, يا أكرم الأكرمين ويا أرحم الراحمين ويا مجيب الدعوة المضطرين، تقبل صلاتنا. اللهم تقبل منا كل صلاة صليناها. اللهم تقبل منا صلواتنا على تقصيرنا وأخطائنا ونسياننا وغفلتنا. اللهم ارزقنا الخشوع في الصلاة. اللهم ارزقنا الخشوع في الصلاة. اللهم ارزقنا الخشوع في الصلاة. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك المصلين المحافظين على الصلاة، واجعلنا مقيما للصلاة ومن ذريتي، ربنا وتقبل دعاء. ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Any questions, sister and brother? Oh, today the late 5 minutes, okay.
I'd like to question about, let's say for example, when do Jumu'ah fall? Is it sunnah? In a day, either before your fardu or after your fardu also can. For example, if you have left, fardu, let's say, like many years, for example, you need to pay. So how would you apply for to do the sunnah? Is it in the day, make sure you do your fardu, or you still, you know, you have to qada before you do your sunnah?
Okay. A person, in some of the his period of his life, he stopped praying. Then he repent to Allah and he come back and pray. If he can account how many salat he missed, he has to pay back. How he pay back? In each fardu, he pray another fard, back up from what he missed. If he knew how many, let's say 1 month he stopped salat, whatever. If a person he cannot account, maybe long period, he try to repent to Allah, truly repent and try to pray back up as much he can, plus the sunnah. That inshallah recover what he doing with a true sincerity and true repent to Allah. If a person never prayed in his life today, let's say a new Muslim, she become a Muslim, or a person, he's a Muslim but he's unaware about Islam and he is not praying for 20 years or long period, he never prayed. If he repent to Allah, truly repent, he doesn't have to back up. According of the madhab Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, because this person, we consider him as a new Muslim. The new Muslim, he doesn't have to back up. Whatever. Consider, because he never prayed before, even Jum'ah. That person, he's 10 years, 20 years, never do Salat. He just, today, he start repent to Allah and he start Salat. So he doesn't have to back up. But a person, he's a Muslim, but he miss many salat, here he has to back up by qada'ah. So if he can account the period, he finishes his period, khalas, no need to back up anymore. But he pray more sunnah in case if he's any things.
So it means that you can apply for sunnah even though you qada'ah, let's say, one fardu, yeah, you know, where you left, and yes, after you still can do your sunnah before and after.
After, yes. Because the sunnah, as I mentioned, fajr 2 raka'ah, dhuhr 4 raka'ah before, 2 raka'ah after, or you can do 4 before and 4 after, or you can do 2 before and 4 after, no problem. For the dhuhr, more flexible. Maghrib, 2 after Maghrib, and Isha, 2 after Isha. This is the sunnah. Whatever after that, we call nafila. Nafila means extra of the extra. We have a fard, we have extra, we have nafila. The third, such as Qiyamul Layl, night prayer, such as Taraweeh, such as Duha, such as Tahiyyatul Masjid, when you come to Masjid, such as Rak'atay al-Wudu, after you do Wudu, you can pray 2 Rak'ah. All this we call Nafila. Nafila. And this is very highly, very high reward by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows the best. Okay, any question? Zakum Allah khair. Any question about Salah? I recommend you to read one book in English. I think they translate to English. They say, As-Salah between Min al-Tahiyyah ila al-Taslim. Between the, Takbir ila al-Taslim. Between the Takbir Allahu Akbar to the Taslim. Salaamu alaikum wa salaamu alaikum. It's in Arabic. When Sheikh Al-Albani, he wrote it. And he mentioned every single things you do from reference from Quran or Hadith. So ruku' from Hadith. He collect all the Hadith referred to ruku'. Hadith of sujood. Hadith, what I should mention in this position, to this position. So it's very nice book, mention all with a reference. Not only like just you have to do this. How I do? I don't know. So all the reference there. It's really, I recommend people to read it. I think it translates to English. If you look in internet about it, I think you can find. Also, there is a YouTube, how to perform Salat. It's in YouTube. One of our, my friend, his name is Sheikh Bilal Dannoun. He did documentary for 1.5 hours in YouTube. Also, I recommend you to watch it. Just put how to perform Salat. Sheikh Bilal Dannoun, the one he explaining. Very nice one. From Australia, that Sheikh. So this is also help you to more understand about the Salah and the rules of Salat. And Allah knows the best, inshallah. And plenty of books also in Ba'as Malayu, I'm sure you have plenty of books. Subhanallah. But I am more recommended to understand the Salah from the root and the references. Because many of us, we read the book just telling you what you should do. But do I know all the evidence and references? So better, I will be more understand the things in Salat. More wide mind. Allah knows. Zakum Allah khair, barakallah fikum. Because some of the people I saw, if you pray behind an imam and he did not say Bismillah, some of them they pray repeat the Salat. Come on, brother. Nabi Sallam, he did it. So this is because he's narrow-minded. He follow Imam Shafi'i, said we should say Bismillah, khalas Bismillah, as like a Quran coming. No, we have to understand where is the Sunnah, where is the Fardu, where is Wajib, and is it okay I pray behind of a person who did not say Bismillah loudly? Yes, Nabi Sallam did it. Nabi Sallam pray silently and loudly the Bismillah. So when I understand the rules, I will not fall in mistakes. You understand? So this is more good to go to references. So I understand this way is accurate. For example, there's a hadith mentioned about you pray, you put your hand in your chest, in lower chest. All this authentic hadith. So if, my ustaz teach me here, this imam, bad imam, I cannot pray behind him. No, two hadith mentioned that Nabi Sallam one time, he pray like this. It's more easier for ummah. And that is narrow-minded, we don't want. You know, I teach my son, this is a way of salah. Other than that is wrong. So this is also a wrong understanding the Islam. Make our Islam so difficult. Or very narrow. Because we are lack of knowledge. Yes, sister, you want to ask?
When we are reciting, Fatiha, the important ayat, then we don't know what we are saying because there's so many things flashing in our mind. We repeat the Fatiha again.
If you have a doubt that you didn't recite Al-Fatiha, you should repeat. If you have a doubtful, did I recite Fatiha or not? you should recite if you have a doubtful. But if you are surely you recited, you don't have to waswas. You know, we call waswas. This is from shaitan. You just ignore it. Sometimes I saw people, oh man, you make me crazy. Please say it, Allahu Akbar, and make me relax. Oh, yeah. I said, I'm waiting the khushu' come. Khushu' has not come from the sky. It can't come from your heart. Only one. We never see Sahaba did it. We never see this here. Rasulullah, he used to do, is Islam or what is Islam you learn, man? Wake up, brother. You just say, Allahu Akbar, that's it. You are inside the salat. You don't do, you make everybody confused. This is what we call waswas. One time in the Salaf, a person, he repeat his wudu maybe 20 times. Subhanallah. So a person, he give him a hit. He said, khalas, no more waswas. He said, khalas, you account one time, that's it. You, the hand, one time you do, this we call waswas. Sometimes, I do. This is a play in your mind until you become sick. Some people, they have a disease of waswas. Khalas, if I remember I did it, I don't have to repeat it. I shouldn't repeat it. Even if I remember I had wudu, look at the Islam, how easy. If I remembered I had wudu, and I do not remember I missed my wudu, you don't have to do wudu. For example, I remember I had wudu from before I come here, from my house. And I did not remember during the way I did something that missed my wudu. I can do salat. I don't have to, maybe I did something waswas, I have to do wudu. You can do salat. So the Islam teach us easy way. Salah is very easy, very soft, very nice. We don't want to have any waswas. We don't have to do the, some people I pray behind them so much make me disease, sick. He said, "Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim." Okay, brother, take it easy, man. This is what I said. No, Imam al-Shafi'i said that I have to pronounce Surah al-Fatiha 100%. Seen must be like, okay. But Islam did not teach us to be so much extremely this way, you know. Al-mustaqim, that's it. Okay, this is what we call extremely people not understanding Islam properly. They call ghulu. Ghulu means so extreme in the things. We know the fardu ayn, we know what is the wajib, we know what is the sunnah, we have to do, okay, without extremism in anything. In anything. وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجِ. Allah did not make the deen haraj, hardness. Allah made the deen is easy for us. You understand how it is. So we learn the Islam from the right reference, from the right ustaz, from the right things. You more you learn, you more your mind become wide. You see how beautiful Islam is? Not like the way they taught us. So difficult. Okay, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair. Wa ahsan Allahu ilaykum. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.